Okay, so I want to finally address a question that I have been getting for a long time now. I just prioritize other videos, so sorry I haven't gotten to it yet, but what are the best universities to attend for marine biology? If you think you might want to be a marine biologist, which I know many of you do, what university is the best one for you to go to? Okay, so I'm going to try to answer this as honestly as I possibly can. There are many, many, many universities and colleges around the world, and many of them are awesome for different disciplines, right? So what I would say is the very best universities for a career in marine biology are going to be universities that have a strong research program in biological sciences and or marine sciences. If you can get both, that's fantastic. But either one of those will be, I think, pretty critical for that university to serve you well. What I mean specifically is you want to go to a university that has active researchers that are working on the kinds of topics of research that interest you. So if you're just broadly interested in marine biology, it means you're broadly interested in biology. So they don't have to be marine people. You don't have to be on a coastline. I was inland. I was in Austin, Texas, a fair way away from a marine environment. You don't need that. You need people that are experts in the kinds, again, of topics and questions that interest you most. And the reason you want that is because you want to be able to interact with those people. You want to be able to take classes from them and learn from them in the traditional school sense, but you also want to try your best to learn from them through internships and direct interactions where you're actually doing research as maybe a volunteer lab assistant in their lab group. This is where you will learn the most in college. Undergraduates that get research experience are far more likely to succeed in graduate school and to even discover that they want to go to graduate school, to learn that they really want to go. Otherwise, if you don't have any research experience and you think you want to go to grad school to be a researcher, you don't really know what you're asking for. So I would argue you really need to get that experience, and to get that, you need to go to a university that has active researchers working on topics that interest you. And you may not know exactly what topic interests you the most, so I would say the best universities would be ones that have individuals that work on multiple topics that sound really cool to you. If they sound cool to you, then you can start, again, interacting with those folks, learning more about those things when you're in college, and then make your best, your most informed decision about which of those areas of research are the ones that you actually want to directly get your hands dirty in. You want to get in there and get some work done in there and learn if it's really for you. So that's really it. If you thought I was going to name off specific universities, I don't need to do that, because really what it comes down to is you have to do the homework. You have to go and research which universities have active researchers, have a strong Department of Biology or Biological Sciences, a strong Marine Science Department, and then much more importantly, I would argue, than even that is what kind of folks are working there, what kind of research are they doing, what kinds of professional researchers could you develop a relationship with and work with and be mentored by? Those are the kinds of questions that you really want to be asking yourself and answering. And so listing off, this university is the best, this university is the best, I could speak to that a little bit about certain regions of the world, but there's great universities all over the place. And as an undergraduate, it's not essential that you go to a university that is the best at marine biology. Like, you don't need that at that point. You need research experience from a legitimate, respected university that has active researchers that are interested in getting undergraduates involved with their work. That's the number one thing I would argue. So lucky for you, there are many, many universities that would fall under that umbrella. And as you are more aware of the specifics of your interests, then you can narrow that list down, in many cases, considerably. So I hope that helps. And if you have more specific questions about this, leave them in the comments, and I will try my best to address them in future videos. Thanks for watching, guys. I don't have to tell you this, but your support, your viewing of these videos, your sharing of these videos, your subscribing, your liking, all that stuff, that's what keeps this stuff going. By reaching more people, I know that I'm actually spreading awareness about science, and that's the whole point of all of these videos. So keep doing that. Keep supporting. It's much appreciated.